Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today I wanted to discuss a very important setting within Apple Photos in regards to importing your photographs into a library versus not a library, which makes it a reference library, which let's just dive in so that you can see the differences. Here we go. So we're going to start by opening up Apple Photos. The first thing we're going to do is go up to Photos and choose Settings. Keep in mind, this particular Mac that I'm on is running Ventura, which is the new operating system not yet released to the mass public, so it's still in beta mode. So chances are, if you're on a previous or current operating system, it's going to say Preferences instead of Settings. This is one of the changes that they're doing in the upcoming software. But when you go to Settings, everything is still going to look very, very similar. Now, there's one preference that I want to call out that is extremely important for how Apple Photos handles the files that you import into Apple Photos. And that's located under the General tab down here under Importing. So this box that says Copy Items to the Photos Library is really, really important. And the reason it's important is because we really want to have a good understanding of where our actual files live on our computer. So there's really two different options. You can have Apple Photos manage the location of all of your photos and videos that you import by having this checked. It means that it's copying the items into the library itself. So it's all self-contained in one particular file or one particular location. So with this box checked, if I open up the Finder and I go to the Pictures folder, this Photos library actually is a giant container that holds all of the photos and videos that you import into Apple Photos. So whenever I import a photograph, because this item here is checked, it's automatically putting all of your photographs into this single library, which makes it easy to, number one, locate and manage. But if you ever needed to free up space on your computer and move this library to an external hard drive to free up space, if you are running into that scenario, I do have a video that I'll link down below in the description that will help you moving your iPhoto library or Apple Photo library to an external hard drive. But the concept is the library, it's all self-contained. And the big thing also is if you use iCloud Photos, it specifically states only items copied to the library will upload to iCloud Photos. This is really, really important. Let's pretend that this is unchecked. And when it's unchecked, these photographs that you import become referenced files. So that means if you have a file on your desktop and you import it into that library, it's creating a link between that location and it's referenced. So let's actually walk through that. As of right now, all of these photographs are copied into this particular library, and they're all in the Pictures folder in this main library here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna quit out of Photos, and I'm gonna create a brand new Photos library, because you can actually have multiple Photos libraries for a variety of reasons. You could archive your old ones out into 2020 pictures, 2021 pictures, 2000 pictures, 1999 pictures, whatever it may be. But we're gonna go ahead and create a new one so I can create a library to show you how referenced files work. I'm gonna go ahead and hold down Option on the keyboard, and then while holding down Option, I'm gonna click on Photos, and it's gonna prompt me with a few options. I can either open up the existing library that I have, I can choose another library if it's located on an external hard drive, if I have that plugged in, but for me, I wanna choose Create New. Now this is gonna prompt me then, what do I wanna call it? And I'm gonna say Referenced Photo Library. We'll store it right in the Pictures folder, and I'm gonna choose OK. This library is completely empty. There's no photographs in it whatsoever. And I'm going to go up to Photos, choose Settings, or Preferences, go to the General tab and uncheck this box so that the photographs are not imported into this library. It even gives me a warning, only items copied into the library will upload to iCloud Photos. That's perfectly fine. So I'll click OK, and then I'm gonna close this out. Now, what I should have done is had some photographs to import, which I don't think I do. Oh, I do. Okay, perfect. So I have two folders here, and all I'm gonna do is drag them into Apple Photos. And what's going to happen is it's going to import them. But the thing is, it's only importing the referenced information. It's actually not importing the actual original file of these photographs. Let's wait for this to be done here. Okay, so the import is done. And you'll notice that in the top right of each photo, it has not only the little pin to represent a GPS location, but it's got the little, kind of looks like a little hard drive. That means that these photographs are referenced to some other location. Now, if I double click on this photo, I can still see that little icon. It doesn't really tell me that it's referenced other than this little icon in the top right. Now, if you don't see this little icon, it's because you need to go to View in the top, choose Metadata, and go down to Referenced File and check that. So notice if I uncheck it, that option went away, and now I don't see it on any of the photographs. So I for sure want to go to View, Metadata, and choose Referenced File, and honestly, turn them all on because it's just a good reference to see all of those little icons. So I'm gonna turn that back on. The thing is, if I move this to the side, let's go back to the Finder here. Notice how small of a file this is. If I open up the information on this folder here, we have 1.68 gigabytes worth of photographs in this folder, and we have 147 megabytes in the Swans folder. But this library itself is only 25 megabytes. So what that means is these pictures here from these two folders were not copied into the library, they're referenced. Let's say I move these folders. So I move them out of the pictures folder. We're just gonna go ahead and drag them to the desktop here. So we've taken them out. So now what happens is, if I go back to Apple Photos here, notice what happened on the little icons. They all had this little question mark in the top right, and it says referenced file offline. So if I go and double click on one of these pictures, it's gonna say, hey, sorry, missing file. Photos with unavailable original files cannot be opened. The original photo file name is either offline or cannot be found. Click Find Original to reconnect. So because I moved those folders off to the desktop here, from the pictures folder, it was only looking for these photos because they were referenced from the original import location in the pictures folder. So what I could do is choose Find Original, and I could say, well, yeah, this picture lives actually not anymore in the pictures folder. It lives in the desktop in the Swans folder, and I can say choose folder. And now notice the little icon back in the top right. It went and found that reference and it reconnected all of those. All of the Swan pictures are now relinked, but the photographs for the Lutzen are not. They still have the question mark. So if I double clicked on any of these, same thing. It's gonna pop up saying, hey, it's not there. You need to find the original. The hard part is if later down the road, if you don't have these little indicators and if you're not going into your photos and these folders that you have referenced get deleted. So if I go ahead and drag Lutzen into the trash, and we're just gonna empty this because worst case scenario, this is kind of what could happen. We empty the trash and now all of these photographs, they still have the thumbnail within Apple Photos, but I can't do anything with these pictures. And I can't find the original because I'm like, well, I don't know where the original is. So that's a huge problem. If your photos are referenced and they accidentally get deleted, you won't have any photographs anymore now Apple Photos, because from that preference or setting that we chose, we told it not to copy into the photos library. So this can be a good thing or a bad thing. If you understand where your pictures are at and you don't like the organization of Apple Photos, you can set up a whole structure of organization with your folder structures and just have everything referenced and really do a lot of your organization of your original files from folders, but just reference them into Apple Photos and still take advantage of the editing tools, some of the keywords, and you can still do albums and all of that in addition to the folder organization that you would do in the Finder. But just keep in mind, if you ever want to use iCloud Photos, none of those pictures are going to go into iCloud Photos and then synchronize to your phone or your iPad or other computer. And if you like the concept of taking a picture on your phone and it going to your computer, or importing photographs into Apple Photos and it shows up on your phone wirelessly, then you need that box checked so that the photos live in the library so that they can go to iCloud Photos. Now, let's say that you have a whole bunch of referenced files like this and you're like, well, I don't want them referenced anymore. I want them to be in that photo library. Oops, I made a mistake. I want to actually keep them in the library all self-contained. So there's a nice little trick that you can do. You can actually select a photograph and go up to File and choose Consolidate. And if I do that, it's going to say this action will actually copy that photograph from its referenced location and put it into the library. So I'm going to choose copy, and you'll notice on this one photograph now, this picture lives now in the library. So naturally I can go back to this swans folder and I would be able to delete that once I've consolidated and copied them in there. The other option that you have from that file menu is I select another photograph and I choose file. I can say, show me this reference file in Finder because I don't know where it's at. So it's actually going to show up and say, oh, it's directly in this 2021 swans folder. It lives on the desktop and it's in iCloud Drive. So that's where that photo actually lives. Another nice thing that you can do is you can create a smart album. And we can say photo. If you're not familiar with smart albums allow you to create a set of rules or criteria, and then it will automatically always find photos based off of the information you've set. So I'm gonna keep it as photo is, and I'm gonna go down to the bottom and choose referenced, and we're gonna say referenced photos and choose okay. So now with this referenced photos smart album, it's gonna show me all photographs that are referenced within Apple Photos, which is kind of nice. Now keep in mind, it's still showing me all of these Lutzen ones, but I deleted the original files and I can't get them back now. So I'm out of luck. Unless I have a backup of those photos, there's nothing I can do with these pictures. I have the tiny thumbnail, but that's literally it. I don't have any of the high resolution anymore. But let me show you a better example. I'm gonna close out of this photo library. I'm gonna hold down Option on the keyboard and open up Photos again. But this time I'm gonna choose my main photo library, which is connected to iCloud. So here I created a smart album. I labeled it Photos Not in the Library. I guess I could have did Photos Reference, but if I right click on it and choose Edit Smart Album, it's the same exact criteria. Photo is referenced. So actually I'll just put referenced photos. All right, and then I could make another smart album if I really wanted to and say Photos is not referenced, which I should have all of the photos. So actually I'll call this one Photos in Library and choose okay. So you'll notice Photos in Library, that's gonna be all of my photos because everything is inside of Apple Photos. But if I go to settings, let's go and uncheck. So I've already unchecked this option. Let's import these Swan photos again. So I'm gonna go to desktop, because now when I drag this into the library, it's gonna say, hey, say yes, apply to all duplicates, and choose import. So now all of those Swan photographs are imported in there, and notice they have the little icon of referenced. And if I come to my smart albums over here on the left, I have, again, photos in the library, but if I choose reference photos, all of that Swan photos should show up there, and it does. It's creating that link between the two. If I wanted these pictures to then be copied into the library, I don't have to re-import them. I can select them, go to File, and choose Consolidate, and it will go ahead and copy that photograph into the reference library, and all is well. And I can do that with all of them too. I could just select all of these photographs, hold down Shift on the keyboard, select from the first one to the last one, and go to File, choose Consolidate, and copy them all in. And so now I have no more referenced photographs. I can safely remove and delete this picture or that folder. Let's empty the trash, get rid of it. So now all of the photographs are inside of this library, and eventually Apple Photos will go and find the duplicates and I can merge them together. So if I go back to the Finder, go to Pictures, all of the pictures are now in this main library that holds 68.44 gigabytes versus the other one, which is very small. That's kind of the difference between the libraries that are referenced and ones that are not. Just keep in mind that if you're doing referenced, you are 100% reliable on yourself for organizing the folders and the pictures that you import into Apple Photos. But just know that if you delete them out of the Finder, you're gonna not really have anything to work with within Apple Photos. So that's pretty much the difference between reference libraries and regular libraries and that very important setting within preferences of Apple Photos. So thank you so much for watching. If you want to continue to support my channel, go ahead and hit that thanks button below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and click like. If you learned something new, go ahead, hit that subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.